at theguard.com here with Mark Henry. Mark is UFC champion Frankie Edgar's stand-up coach. How you doing, Mark?
All right, how's it going, man?
Congratulations on Frankie's victory against BJ Penn.
Thank you.
And the stand-up was really what that fight was all about. And Frankie's stand-up has always been really, really good. You're training him. Tell us about your training techniques and what Frankie's doing on the stand-up.
What Frankie's doing, he's just, you know, it's not just the boxing. It's just, it's everything. He's doing everything. You know, Phil's helped out so much with the... you know, with the kicking now and the feints, and, you know, we pretty much have the same philosophy on the style, so it works out really well, and just everything changed for us when we went to Ricardo. Ricardo's phenomenal. Ricardo's not just a jiu-jitsu coach, he's an MMA coach, and he's just a phenomenal brain and an unbelievable asset. And, you know, he's had some phenomenal sparring partners too. You know, Eddie Alvarez, Ricardo, Chris Liguori, they're in combat champion. Tom DeBlass, the Miller brothers, and also boxing, which I think really helps a lot, is Dennis Mama's boy from Freehold, who's a phenom in boxing. He's incredible, and we hook up with him a lot too, so he's helped out tremendously. So it's definitely a team effort, not a boxing thing, but MMA thing.
You focus on his boxing, and you mentioned Phil. That's crew Phil Nurse.
Yes, crew Phil Nurse. It's just all a team effort. Everybody just always comes together, and, you know, like I train Ricardo too, so we all have the same, kind of all share the same brain, and you know, in the stand-up game, it's everybody, and just in every asset too. Like I've been trying to work more, Frankie, on all around, trying to get away from boxing, though, but mainly boxing. Just trying to, you know, we're all trying to just be better, you know, and being better is being, you know, all around in Muay Thai. You know, wrestling, jiu-jitsu, boxing, everything. Being the ultimate, you know, MMA fighter.
Now, you know, I know you're working well with crew Phil, and everything is good. But was there a little bit of, like, concern on your part, you know, to kind of move to that Muay Thai kind of training?
No, not at all. You know, it's you know, Phil's great in that, you know, he kind of stays with your style. He really didn't try to change anything. And, you know, it was pretty much the same style. You know, we all told Frankie, Ricardo and I, you know, everybody on the team, Steve from Elite Wrestling, you know, he's part of the team also. We all, you know, kind of pushed him in that direction because he's the best. And it just worked out well in that when we went there, that, you know, it just worked out the same style. It's even funny too, because I'll speak to Frankie in different codes sometimes or languages, and he'll be in one corner and I'll be saying something and Phil doesn't know what I'm saying. And he'll roll over to the other corner. You know, I've asked him in the past, you know, do we confuse you sometimes? He says, no, you're saying one thing in one language, and I get over to Phil and he's telling me the same exact thing. So, you know, when that type of thing happens, it's, you know, it works out well. Ricardo, I trained him, so he has the same exact, not the same exact style, but we have the same concepts. So, you know, Ricardo has such an input on the stand-up and the all-around MMA too. I mean, he's just phenomenal. Ricardo, really, really excited for him against Matt Hughes August 7th also. Just so excited. And Tom tonight, Tom DeBlass, you know, just, I think he's going to be really good, you know. I worked with Chris Wink too. He's going to be great too tonight. Just want to throw out those guys tonight. He did a phenomenal job there. So, you know, I always say too, it's, you know, even an old ugly guy like me looks good in a Ferrari. And right now, you know, I'm just blessed that these guys are all Ferraris and Lamborghinis. Anybody can look good in them. They're all phenomenal athletes, you know. Anybody could do a great job with these guys. They're just phenomenal.
Well, you know what? There's plenty of phenomenal athletes who don't have those kind of hands. And, you know, Frankie's boxing, you know, he's beautiful. Muay Thai, his stand-up is really coming along. Made him a UFC champion.
Yeah, it's everything, though. Like, I'm telling you, BJ knew it was just stand-up. And he didn't have the shots in the wrestling that Steve's worked on with the kid, or didn't have the confidence in jiu-jitsu for Ricardo, all the other stuff Ricardo works on so hard with, that, you know, it wouldn't all came together, and it all came together. It totally just wasn't, you know, it was everything. You know, today, you know, more than anything, that you just have to be an all-around, you know, MMA fighter these days. Everybody's getting so good, and, you know, you just have to keep progressing every fight. Everybody's getting tremendous from one fight to the next. You're like, is that the same guy? So, you know, and that's where Frankie and Ricardo and Tom and all these guys, Chris Ligori also, he's doing phenomenal, has a fight next week. We're so excited for that one. And he helps out so much too with Frankie and just insight and everything. And, you know, they all just do a great job. And like I'm saying, BJ, he knows we're not just coming out the box. It was the feints on the kicks. It was the kicks. It was the wrestling. It was the confidence that he knew he has a ground game in jiu-jitsu. It's the corner, Ricardo, keeping him calm. So, you know,
now
it's
all
the team.
Now he has to do the whole thing all over again.
Yeah.
Five more rounds.
Yeah, we're excited. We're excited. I think that it's way better to, you know, fight BJ again. You beat the next six contenders, and it's not the same as beating BJ. I mean, you know, BJ Penn, you know, is one of the greatest of all time, and you know, and I believe that, and we know that, you know, and now we're trying to make a legacy of our own, and you know, we don't think of BJ, we know he's phenomenal, but we just try to think of BJ and his style and type of fighter he is, and try to get away from that other stuff. I think that's why Frankie does so well, because he could kind of disconnect, you know, the, you know, worried about who BJ is, which he deserves all the credit he gets, and just think about BJ as a style and a fighter, and that's what he does very well, and all the guys do very well.
All right, Mark Henry, thanks very much. I appreciate the interview.
You got it, man. Thanks so much, man.